I'm going to talk about, but we're going to graph that 8x squared plus 5 squared of 3xy plus 3y squared minus 10 equals 0 with a calculator, as opposed to rotating the axis and doing it by hand. You know, check your work, if you will. Okay, so if we're going to get this into our graphing calculators, we need to get it, you know, so that it's y in terms of x. And our graphing calculator, at least all the ones that I've used, I'm sure there's something out there, you know, doesn't deal with rotated rotated axis. So we need to write this so that it's y in terms of x. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go back to this example here where we have ax squared plus bx plus c. And, you know, when you have a squared term and a single degree term, you're not going to just solve that equation by isolating the x because, well, you have this term has got two of them and this term's got one. And so these two terms are not going to combine. They're not like terms. And we have to solve it, you know, well, there's a few ways to solve it. We can solve it by factoring. We can solve it by the quadratic equation. And you can also solve it by completing the square. And by the way, if you've never seen it, you know, you can derive the quadratic formula by taking our quadratic equations and going through the in general form with no, you know, all the variables in it, and go through the completing the square process to derive that equation. I'll put a link to that in the description of this as well. And you'll notice that I have an x squared and I have an x to the single degree of 1. And when I go into the quadratic formula, I only have to write x once. So that's what that idea here of single degree, squared, working through the quadratic formula, there's a lot of action going on over here between the combinations of a, b, and c, but there's only one x. Now if I do that same idea with this problem, I'll be able to write it so that there's only one y, and get it into my calculator, my graphing calculator. So we're going to write 3y squared plus 5 square root of 3xy. So I'm going to, you know, wanting to write this so that it's y in terms of x, so that I want to write this so that there's only one variable of y and it's isolated just like this x is here. I'm going to put that squared term first. I'm going to put this single degree term first. I'm just focusing on the y. And then we're going to write everything else off to the side. So we have plus 8x squared minus 10 is equal to 0. Now, again, thinking about this idea of having coefficients of a, b, and c, that means that my value of a is going to be 3. B is going to be equal to 5 square root of 3x, and c is going to be that constant or whatever is left in this equation that does not have a y squared, it does not have a y to the first, just whatever is left over, and that means c is going to be equal to 8x squared minus 10. And so y, going through the quadratic formula, y is equal to, let's see here, the opposite of b, so we're going to have negative 5 square root of 3x plus or minus, so we have the opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared. So again, b being that coefficient of this variable with the single degree, that's going to be 5 square root of 3x squared. So here's my b squared minus 4a, my coefficient of my squared term, which is going to be 3, so 4ac. And again, everything that does not have basically a factor of y in it, or, you know, again, here's my y, I'm repeating what I just said, I apologize, 5 squared of 3x. Every other term is going to be our value of c. So we have 4ac, 8x squared minus 10, all of that over opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, all over 2a. And again, that a value is 3. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to step off. We're going to just clean this up a little bit. Not really necessary to put in the graphing calculator, but I think that's good practice. And then we're going to go into getting this into a TI Inspire, see what that graph looks like, hopefully just like it did in our previous work in this problem where we graphed it by hand. And with that plus or minus, by the way, you're going to see that I'm going to have to type in an equation for the plus and a separate equation for the minus, basically graphing the upper half and the lower half of that ellipse. All right, so let's get to that right now.
Okay, so now that we have our equation set up through the quadratic and simplified, we're just going to go to our graphing calculator, toggle over to our graphing window, and we're going to type in fractions. So we're going to do control fraction, and we have negative 5 square root of 3x. I'm going to arrow this over, get out of the square root symbol. X, we're going to do plus the square root again of negative 21 x squared plus, sorry, I'm trying to look for my notes here, plus 121, plus 120 over that denominator of 6. And we're going to hit enter. And hopefully, there we go. We see the top half of that rotated ellipse. We're going to go ahead and hit the tab button to open up that entry window again. Type in the exact same thing. Try and make it a little bit faster this time. 5, negative 5, square root of 3, arrow over x, minus now this time. So we get the bottom half. The square root of negative 21 x squared plus 120 all over again 6. Whoops, I didn't want that to happen. Oh, I didn't say I wanted to put in a fraction. Let's do this. Let's open up the parentheses and hopefully, yes, that has wrapped that entire what's going to be our numerator in parentheses, hit division, and put that over 6. So there you go. You have two ways of seeing how to enter this. And there we go. We have the top half and the bottom half of our ellipse, and it's looking like it matches the same graph that we got when we did this by hand and rotated those axes 30 degrees. Now,